माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डिस्कस द लेशन नंबर 7 ओवर कंट्री इंडिया एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइजेस। नंबर फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इज एंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस ब्रीफली एंड फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज नेम द मेजर फिजिकल डिविजन्स ऑफ इंडिया। नेम द मेजर फिजिकल डिविजन्स ऑफ इंडिया। सो आंसर इज इंडिया इज मार्क्ड बाय अ डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ फिजिकल फीचर्ड सच एज माउंटेन्स प्लाट्यूज प्लेन्स कोस्ट एंड आइलैंड्स। आंसर इज इंडिया इज मार्क्ड बाय अ डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ फिजिकल फीचर्ड सच एज माउंटेन्स प्लाट्यूज प्लेन्स कोस्ट एंड आइलैंड्स। ओके, आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द आंसर वेरी वेल। नेक्स्ट, इंडिया शेयर्स इट्स लैंड बाउंड्रीज विथ 7 कंट्रीज, नेम देम। We discussed on page number 48 India's neighbors. When we look the map of India, then we find that India shares its boundaries with 7 countries. So there are 7 countries that share land boundaries with India. We look that these countries are Afghanistan, Pakistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar. Okay, so when we write the answer in grammatical format, we write the answer, India shares its land boundaries with 7 countries. These countries are such as Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, China, Myanmar, Nepal and Pakistan. Okay, and we may use a trick to memorize it. ABBCMNP ABBCMNP A goes for Afghanistan, B goes for Bangladesh, and second B goes for Bhutan, C goes for China, M goes for Myanmar, N goes for Nepal, and P goes for Pakistan. A, B, B, C, M, N, P. Okay? A, B, B, C, M, N, P. Okay? So answer is India shares its land boundaries with 7 countries. These countries are such as Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, China, Myanmar, Nepal and Pakistan. Okay? Next question. The question is which 2 major rivers fall into the Arabian Sea? Which 2 major rivers fall into the Arabian Sea? Answer is, we discussed on page number 51 that the rivers Narmada and Tapi flow through these ranges, and these ranges are the Vindhyas and the Satpuras are the important ranges we discussed. The rivers Narmada and Tapi flow through these ranges. These are west flowing rivers that drain into the Arabian Sea. So correct answer is Narmada and Tapi rivers fall into the Arabian Sea. Answer is Narmada and Tapi rivers fall into the Arabian Sea. Okay, answer is Narmada and Tapi rivers fall into the Arabian Sea. Next question is, name the delta formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Name the delta formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. We discussed on page number 52 that the Sundarban Delta is formed where the Ganga and Brahmaputra flow into the Bay of Bengal. So correct answer is the Sundarban Delta is formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Okay, the Sundarban Delta is formed by the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Okay, we have discussed A, B, C and D. Next, the question is E. How many states and union territories are there in India? Which states have a common capital? Okay, so answer is there are 29 states and 9 union territories in India. Andhra Pradesh and Telangana have a common capital such as Hyderabad. Answer is there are 29 states and 9 union territories in India. Andhra Pradesh and Telangana have a common capital such as Hyderabad. I hope you have understood very well A, B, C, D and E. Next, we are going to answer the question F. Next question is F. Why do a large number of people live in northern plains? Why do a large number of people live in the northern plains? We discussed on page number 51 that the northern Indian plains lie to the south of the Himalayas. They are generally level and flat. These are formed by the alluvial deposits laid down by the rivers, the Indus, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra and their tributaries. Okay, these river plains provide fertile land for cultivation. That is the reason for high concentration of population in these plains. So we write the correct answer in grammatical format and in a proper structure. A large number of people live in the northern plains because the plains are flat and in level. These are formed by the alluvial deposits and fertile land for cultivation. Okay? So, answer is a large number of people live in the northern plains because the plains are flat and in level. These are formed by the alluvial deposits and fertile land for cultivation. You can take a screenshot of green board and write the answer in your notebook. Next question is G. We are going to answer the question G. Next question is G. Why is Lakshadweep known as a coral island? Why is Lakshadweep known as a coral island? Lakshadweep islands are called as the coral islands because they have been formed from the skeletons of tiny marine animals called polyps. Okay, answer is Lakshadweep islands are called as the coral islands because they have been formed from the skeletons of tiny marine animals called polyps. Today we have discussed in the exercises, first number exercise A, B, C, D, E, F and G. In the next video, we will discuss the question number 2 and 3. I hope you have understood very well these answers. Keep continue with me. Thank you.